In this tutorial, I'm gonna show you, first of all, how Magic Mask works in DaVinci Resolve, but I'm also gonna show you 5 different use cases, 5 creative ways to use Magic Mask, because I've already shown you how to put text behind something or someone, but you can do a lot more with it. It's one of the most useful features that you get when you buy DaVinci Resolve Studio. So yeah, here we go. The basics are actually super simple, and yeah, I know I say that a lot, but in this case it's really, really true, I swear. Because DaVinci Resolve does all the hard work for you. And just so you know, I'm gonna stick to using Magic Mask in the color page for this tutorial, but you can also use Magic Mask in the fusion page if you want to do more advanced effects. So, up to you. Okay, this is our clip, it's selected, and the playhead is over the clip. Then go to the color page and click on this icon here, Magic Mask. That's where we need to be. And then you can select 2 options here, Object Mask and Person Mask. So one is for objects and the other for persons, obviously, but honestly, almost 90% of the times I use Magic Mask, I use Object Mask. I feel like it works best for both objects and people. But of course, if you don't get the results that you want, just try switching to the other one. Okay, and then all you need to do to create a mask is draw over the subject or the object you want to mask. It doesn't even have to be super accurate. And of course, it's always easier to enable the red mask overlay here so you can actually see the mask. Now, if Resolve has missed some areas, you can just add some strokes, so it doesn't have to be one long stroke. You can just add as many strokes as you want to add to the mask. And then if you select this icon here, the dropper with the minus symbol, the strokes turn red. And so you can tell Resolve that you don't want those areas included in the mask. So you can use it to clean up your selection, for example. And you can also do this by holding the Alt key while you're using the dropper with the plus symbol, by the way. See, then it will turn into a minus symbol. And you can just switch between them by holding or releasing the Alt key. And then this icon right here inverts the mask. So if you want the background, then you just invert the mask. Now, if we zoom in, you can see here, especially around the hair, that the edges are a bit rough. But you can easily fix that in one click. Down here, just switch from faster to better. Your computer is gonna have to do a lot more work, but as you can see, it looks a lot better. And then down here, you can use all these sliders and settings to fine-tune the mask even more. Soften it or include or exclude whites or blacks. Okay, and then all you need to do is hit track. Now, I've created my reference frame here in the middle of the clip. See, if I move to the left or the right here, then the mask disappears or my strokes disappear. So I did all those strokes in one frame, the reference frame. So that means that I'm gonna have to track forward and backwards from my reference frame. So first forward, and then once it's done, put the playhead back to the reference frame, and then track backwards. And the blue line means that the tracking went okay, no problems. It'll turn red if there's a problem. Now, if you're checking your mask after it's finished and you see a problem, for example, let's say from this point until the end, Resolve selected too much. Maybe some areas in the background or whatever. Well, then you can just set the playhead there, add a red stroke to remove some areas to tell Resolve that you definitely don't want that to be included, and then just track that part again. And see, it'll turn red, telling you that you need to track that part again because you made some adjustments. And of course, you can also track multiple objects, no problem. So that's the basics. Now let me show you some use cases. 5 creative ways to use Magic Mask in DaVinci Resolve. First, the classic use case, text behind an object or a person in just a few minutes. How does it work? Well, first of all, duplicate your clip and then create your mask in the top clip. So like I've just shown you, let's do it super fast now. Okay, and then once your mask is finished and all looks good, right click here in the node area and add an alpha output. Then this blue thingy will appear. And then just connect the blue output of the node with the blue alpha output. And now the background is gone. I mean, you can't see it yet because we still have that duplicate clip underneath. But see, if I make it invisible, then you can see that the background of the top clip is gone. And so all you need to do now is put your text between these two clips and boom, you're done. It's simple, it's fast. Why would you still do it manually, right? I mean, sometimes you have to do it manually when things get a little bit more complicated or when the tracking, you know, when it's too difficult for Resolve to track something. But in a lot of cases, in most cases actually, this works perfectly. And instead of text, what you can also do is put an object behind an object or a person. So add something in the background, for example. Okay, so it looks a bit over the top maybe, it's not super realistic, but it's just to show you the possibilities and how it works. If you put some more work into it, then you can do some pretty cool and realistic stuff. Now, I'm not gonna show you the entire process because it will take way too long, but basically it's the same as before. Just duplicate your clip, create a mask in the top clip, and then for the bottom clip, I went to the Fusion page and I used the camera tracker to track the movement of the camera so that whatever I put in the background stays in the same place in the background, you know, because the camera is moving. And you can add an image, a 3D object, or a video in the background. That's what I did here, a video. It's pretty cool, right? And I'll link a video in the description that shows you how to use that camera tracker. So it's more work and a bit more difficult, but once you get the hang of it, you can do some pretty cool stuff with this. And then what I use Magic Mask a lot for is color grading. Now, Magic Mask doesn't replace normal power windows, but it's just that sometimes Magic Mask works better and sometimes a normal power window works better. So yeah. So let's say I want to brighten or darken the subject or just mess a bit with the colors. It's super easy, just create a mask and then start messing with the color controls. And like I said, sometimes I use a regular power window, sometimes I use Magic Mask, it just depends. So, you know, it's just a matter of learning when to use Magic Mask and when to use a normal power window. They both have their use cases. And of course, you can also apply all kinds of effects to your masked object. So once you've created your mask, go to Effects here and then drop an effect, whatever you want. Mosaic Blur, for example. There, that's it. It's that easy. You can of course also invert the mask and make the background more blurry with a Gaussian blur, for example. And as you can see, there's a ton of effects that you can use. And the possibilities are pretty much endless. Okay, and then finally, combining Magic Mask with another cool new feature, Relight. So I've used the Relight effect to adjust the lighting in the background of this scene. But the only problem is that it also affects the subject, the lighting of the subject. Now, of course, sometimes that's okay, but what if you don't want that? Well, it's simple. Just add another node, create a mask of the subject with Magic Mask, and then just feed that mask into the Relight node. So connect the blue alpha output with the first blue input of the Relight node, and then go to key here and activate the matte mask icon. That's this one here. And now the subject, or whatever you've masked, magically, is excluded from the Relight effect. Super useful. And that's it. Now, look, guys, you don't have to use Magic Mask for everything, okay? But some things are just easier and faster if you use Magic Mask. And as we all know, time is money, right? So yeah. Thank you so much for watching, and see you in the next one.